Right, second thing is, he's your speech therapist. He doesn't just direct our thoughts, he shapes our words. I'm sure we have all had times when we have put our foot in our mouth. We shouldn't say some of the things that we sometimes do say, and we should say some of the things that we often don't say. Anybody else feeling it today? And God wants to shape our words more and more by prompting speech. It's like he's our prompter in the production called life. Do you ever get that tug in your spirit that whispers, don't say it? But you still go ahead and say it and then live to regret it. Don't go quiet on me. I know you're in the same boat. Don't leave me hanging here on my own. And then there are other times that you get that same tug that whispers, say it, but you don't say it, and then you live to regret that. Turn to the person next to you, give him a nudge and say he's talking about you now. And of course, I'm sure that we all know someone who always seems to say the wrong thing at the wrong time. You're kind of apprehensive around them because you never quite know what is going to come out of their mouth. They live, if you like, with their foot permanently in their mouth. How many of you know that's not good? And if I have just identified you, you need to firmly get your foot out your mouth today. And you would be amazed how much your life would change. See, words, why are people looking at each other? It's like, wasn't meant to be personal. Remember what the scripture said earlier? A person only knows their own thoughts because of what's working within them. So let's not judge, otherwise I have to go into a series of bad. Anyway, of course, I'm, words are some of the most powerful things that we can share. We share and they either help or they hurt. Which are we going to do? Are we going to help or are we going to hurt? Proverbs 15:23 says, it is wonderful to say the right thing at the right time. Did you hear that? It's wonderful. Everybody say wonderful. Now I know what you're thinking. Oh, if only life was as simple as saying the right thing at the right time all the time. Now, I know we can't quite achieve that, but here's what we can do. We can develop a way to say the right thing at the right time, but in order to do so, we've got to rely more and more on God to direct our speech and shape our words by listening for his prompt and hearing his heart. That's the way we say the right thing at the right time. Listen, all of us can say the wrong thing at the wrong time. We don't even need to try. We need to put effort in to saying the right thing at the right time. And if we haven't got the right thing to say, then zip it. And I know for some, and I know maybe even for some of you, that is really hard. No looking at each other. You know what it's like. Come on. You only need pushing. We're all human. You pinch me, I'm going to say ow. So you push me, I'm going to say something. You cut me up on the road, my natural reaction, I don't have to try hard. My natural reaction is to respond. You push a trolley into me in the supermarket, what's my natural reaction? It's not, oh bless you, I've got a big bruise on my thigh now. No, something else comes out. And God wants us to listen in those times to the way that we need to shape our words. How do our words sound? This week, if you think back, what has come out of here? I don't want you to answer me right now because I don't want... What has come out of here? Is it good? Is it bad? Are you proud of it or are you ashamed of it? Are you challenged already and you want me to shut up now and we'll just carry on next week because, hey, this is enough. No, I'm going to carry on. There's one more to do and then we'll go into the next one next week, because I got some stories to tell, and I got some really good stories to tell, and I want to tell them today. So listen up, because he wants to shape some words. Turn to your neighbor and say, listen up, because he wants to shape some words. All right. Now, there was an emphasis too much one way and not the other way then. Some of you know that the person sat next to you needs to hear that more than you. Maybe it is ran the other way. Makes me